Hey there, head squeezers. I hope you're well. This one's come in from Tim McCabe, who asks, why do jellyfish sting? Now, I think it was one of the greatest minds of this, if not any generation, Mr. Carl Pilkington, who said, jellyfish, do we need them? Well, Carl, yes we do, because they are indeed part of the food chain. But I can't deny, they are a bit of an odd beast. They're not even a fish, they're a plankton made of 98% water. They have no bones, no heart, technically even no brain, but they've been around for 650 million years and there are thousands of different species, so clearly they're doing something right. So Tim, the sting, they use it to capture prey and as a defense mechanism. A jellyfish's tentacle is covered in cells called nematocysts, and in those contains stinging threads. If it comes up against a foreign body like a human on the beach, it'll unfurl those stinging threads and shoot out a neurotoxin venom. In the case of its prey, it will paralyze it. In the case of us, it just hurts. Tell me in the comments below if you've experienced that kind of pain before. So, how do you treat for a jellyfish sting? Yes, the urine issue had to come up at some point, didn't it? So, does it actually work? This idea that if you pee on someone's limb that's been stung by a jellyfish, will that help? A recent study suggests no. It actually reckons that it could make the sting burn more. The thing is, a sting tends to be alkaline, so in order to neutralize it, you need acid. So vinegar would be a great thing to pour over your sting. So whoever came up with that idea that you need to take a leak on someone if they've been stung by a jellyfish? I don't know, I couldn't find out, but I salute that person as one of the best practical jokers in history. Until next time, happy head squeezing.